Hi everyone! In this Practicle Math video, we are going to look at an area of triangle math question from Primary 5 and then learn how to solve it together, alright? Now let's read this problem together. ABC and DBE are two right-angled isosceles triangles. So here we have triangle ABC and then we have triangle DBE. As you can see, both of them are right-angled triangles. And this means that it's going to be quite easy to find the base and the height of each of these triangles. Correct? Looking at the bigger triangle ABC, we can take AB as its base. And because CB is perpendicular to it, we can tell that this is going to be the height. Following so far? Then let's look at the smaller triangle DBE. Okay? Do you know what's the base and height of this triangle? The base of triangle DBE is the flat line that we see over here, which is DB, and which side is perpendicular to it? If you say EB, good job! And that's the height of this smaller triangle. Now, the next thing that we need to figure out is what isosceles triangles are. Isosceles triangles are just triangles with two equal sides. So looking at what we have, this means that when we look at the triangle ABC, AB is going to be as long as CB. And what about the smaller triangle? The length of DB must be the same as EB. Correct? Next, we are given that AD equals to CE equals to 4cm. So now we know that these two lengths over here and here are the same. The area of the shaded part is 32 square centimeters. So let's think about what we can tell from that. Okay? When we subtract the area of the smaller triangle DBE from the area of the bigger triangle ABC, the remaining area that we see over here is going to be 32 square centimeters. Do you see that? Now let's see what the question is asking us to solve. What is the length of BE? So it looks like we're supposed to find out how long this part over here is, right? And do you know how to solve that? Now I need all of you to pause this video right now and then try to think about this problem, okay? And once you're ready, you can continue watching to find out if you're right. Are you ready for the answer? Now looking at what we have, you probably know that the 4cm that we have here is just part of the base and height of this bigger triangle, correct? Now the clue that we have over here about the area of the shaded part seems pretty important. But how do we link this to what we have? Well, if you're stuck, that's pretty normal. Now I'm going to show you one little magic trick and help you see the link, alright? Let's move this bigger triangle ABC to the side and watch what happens when we do that. Do you see it? Can you see that when we move this big triangle from the left to the right, this extra length that we have over here is actually the same as 4cm? Now let's watch this one more time in slow-mo, shall we? Can you see it? Now when we move the triangle from the left to the right, not only do we know that this length over here equals to 4cm, can you see that although the shaded part looks different, the shaded part that we have over here is still the same as what we had before. This whole shaded part is still going to be 32 square centimeters because we can still find it by subtracting the area of the smaller triangle from the area of the bigger triangle, right? But the good thing is, instead of having a weird shape that we have no clue what to do, we can divide this shape into two familiar shapes. Can you see a triangle and a rectangle? And these two shapes are going to be much easier to deal with. Now looking at the triangle over here, what can you tell? Can you see that it has a base of 4cm and a height of 4cm? Now let's make use of this to find the area of this blue triangle, okay? To find the area of a triangle, we are going to take half times base times height. And because we know that the base and height is 4 centimeters, half times 4 is going to give us 8 square centimeters. Do you get that? Can you guess what we are going to do next? If you thought of subtracting the area of the blue triangle from the shaded area, that's exactly what we are going to do. So well done for thinking of that. When we subtract 8 square centimeters from 32 square centimeters, what do you get? Do you get 24 square centimeters? If you did, well done. Now that we know the area of the rectangle over here, we are one step closer to finding the answer of BE. Do you know what we can do to find the answer? To find the length of BE, we are going to make use of the formula to find the area of a rectangle, okay? Do you remember what times what gives us the length of a rectangle? I hope you said length times breadth. And if you did, good job. Looking at what we have, we know one side of the rectangle, correct? And we want to find the other side. In other words, 4 times BE is going to give us 24. So to find the length of BE, all we need to do is to divide 24 by 4. And 24 divided by 4 gives us an answer of 6 cm. Do you get that? And that's how we know that the length of BE is 6 cm. So this math problem wasn't as hard as we thought, right? Now that you've learned how to solve this primary 5 area of triangle question, don't forget to check out the other questions that we have in Practicle and see whether you know how to use this trick to solve them, alright? As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon!